Dear students, now we have to see how to transform and how to change from simple to compound and complex to compound method. In exam, how they can ask questions will be asked means two types of questions. First one, if you are asked to change from, let us convert from simple to complex, complex to compound like that, that will be asked. Another form, two sentences will be given. You are asked to join these two sentences by using coordinating conjunctions or subordinating conjunctions. So, two types of questions will be asked in the exam. First one, you are given one sentence, you are asked to change it in, suppose the complex sentence given means you are asked to change it in simple or compound. Another form is, two sentences will be given, separately given two sentences, you are asked to join these two sentences using coordinating conjunctions or subordinating conjunctions. Like that, the question will be asked. First type, we have to see now, type 1, referring to conjunction. So, to keep in your mind, simply remember, we have to keep the keywords in our mind. That is very easy for us to change. For complex, though, or although, or even though, any one you have to select. Plus subject. Subject means doer of the action. Doer. So that is subject, then verb, then main class. That is the format of a complex sentence. Compound sentence, we have to write subject verb. Here we bring the subject verb at first means we have to remove this subordinating conjunction at first. We have to remove that word. First we have to start with subject verb, then write down coordinating conjunction, but, or still, or and yet. Any one you have to write. Maximum we use but, or still, or and yet, plus main class. Then simple sentence, in spite of, this one word, in spite of, or despite, not despite of, despite. Or notwithstanding. Here also, anyone we have to select. Maximum in common we use in spite of or despite. Anyone you can use. Plus ing form or noun form, then main class. You understand? Here we have to first recall them. Complex sentence means we have to select any one word. Though or although or even though, plus subject, plus verb, then main class. In compound sentence, first we have to write subject, verb, then connective word, coordinating conjunction, but, or still, or, and yet, then main class. In simple sentence, in spite of, or despite, or notwithstanding, ing form, or noun form, plus main class. You understand? So, for that, we should know ing form or noun form while writing simple sentence. Let's see that. Let's see noun form and adjective or verb form. By knowing these things only, we can change, that is simple sentence, from complex to simple, simple to complex or compound. This is very important. See this one, for example, few words only I have written for your reference. But if you have to refer your dictionary, with the help of your dictionary, you have to find more words and write up your own and extend this chapter column. Because in a dictionary, so many words are given. And also, more words is very important for us to write down. Write the noun form or adjective form is very important. So, go through dictionary. Here, popularity. This is noun form. For simple sentence only, it is a noun form that will be used. So, popularity is noun form. For adjective, popular. So, noun form we can write either with adjective form or verb. How we can identify adjective or verb? What is adjective? Adjective is a describing word which qualifies noun form. Verb, it denotes action word. Already you know. Here, popular, that is not adjective word. So, this is nature. That is feelings. So, adjective words, you know, describing words. It is about the noun form. Moreover, feelings, colors, taste, these are come under adjective words. Here, popular is adjective word. Popularity, noun form. Popular, adjective word. Richness, noun form. Rich, adjective word. Weakness, noun, weak, adjective. intelligence noun, intelligent adjective. Poverty noun form poor adjective. Carelessness noun form careless adjective. Then come to this one, strength noun form strong adjective word. Come to this, hard work, this is noun form hard work. When we write, that is in this column, we have to write it begin with verb, because hard work noun form, we have to write it work hard. So work or works or worked hard. Why I have written like this means, for present tense we have to write work or works. That is for third person singular, he, she, it, we have to add s to the verb. Yes, es or ies to the verb. For example, here verb we add s only. If we take this verb go, we add s means go plus es. So we get goes. Then in any word that ends with y, study, dy. So if you add s means instead of y we have to write I. So studies, studies. So simply we have to remain in our mind, for third person singular, he, she, it, we have to add s or es or ies to the base form of the verb. That is for present form. Or worked, past tense, worked hard. So according to the tense, we have to write it either in present form or past tense. Present means we have to note down whether the subject is in third person singular means we have to write yes. Otherwise no need. I work hard. If you write she means she works hard. Past tense means worked hard. Come to next one, heavy rain. This is noun form. When we write, that is in a verb form means rains or rained heavily. Here rains. Because for rain we use it subject. For he, she, we have to add s to the verb. So rains, past tense means rain heavily. L-Y means adverb. Heavy rain, that is changed like this. Rains or rain heavily. Next one, heavy loss. This is noun form. We have to write lose or loses or lost heavily. Here this one present tense, lose or loses. Here this one lost, L-O-S-S, lost. That is noun form. When we convert as a verb means we have to pronounce as lose. L-O-S-E, lose or loses or lost heavily. Lost past tense. Here lose present tense, loses. For he, she, third person singular, we have to add s to the verb. Next one, growth. This is noun form. We have to write with verb form grow. Present tense grow or grows or past tense grew. So like that we have to change. So from noun form to adjective or verb we have to change. So for some words only I have given. Given by this you can that is make yourself the remaining words. That's very easy for you to convert this. Yes students, let's see. Complex, compound, simple. First type we are going to see now. Here simply you can remember. Complex means though, or, although, or, even though. This word enough. No need to memorize all these things. Just for your understanding only I have written. Just while for preparing for exam oriented means, just keeping this mind in your mind. Though, or, although, or, even though, in one. Then for compounded, but, still, or, and yet. Yet also you can write. But, maximum we use but. Then simple, in spite of or despite. These two words enough. Now come to this, we have to see example how we can convert, how we can transform. This is a transformation. See this example. Although she is weak, come on, she attends office. That is complex. CX represents complex. CD compound, yes, simple. Here see this, although, here this word present here, so the sentence is in complex. Now we have to change from complex to compound very easy. In all the times, complex to compound to complex very easy. Because like maths, you have to just remove this word, then in between two sentences write down conjunction word. Just a substitution only. So here remove this word although, then you will get two sentences. This one already I told you. A complex sentence contains one main class, one subordinate class. main class means complete meaning, subordinate class means incomplete meaning, which depends on main class to complete its meaning, as we know. So all those she is with subordinate class, she attends office main class. Then this one incomplete meaning, if we remove this word although, we will get complete meaning sentence, she is being, meaning completed. Here, while writing compound sentence, here two sentences are joined by a coordinating conjunction, but then we will get compound sentence. You understand? So now write down, she is being, but she attends office. Here also since you can't understand clearly, she is weak, but she attends office. Opposite manner. So like that, it's one compound sentence. While changing into simple sentence, first you have to write with in spite of. Write down in spite of. Next we have to write possessive noun. Here she take this sentence, she is subjective, that is the pronoun. Here we have to write with possessive noun. She into her, he, his, I, my, we, are, they, there, like that you have to change. In spite of, here she changes into her. Next one, write down noun form. This only I told you by this tablet column, you know. Weak adjective word, weak noun form, weakness. So write down, in spite of her weakness. We have written up to this. Here this one compound. So we have to remove this word, but. Next one, she attends office, write down here. Could come out. So this sentence is simple. You understand? In spite of her weakness, she attends office. This is in simple. And also, we have to write with noun form or ing form. Here, noun form we have written. Weak noun form, weakness. Now we have to write with ing form. So both if you know means, in the exam you can write anyone. No need to write both sentences in the exam. Anyone you know means you can write. That is somewhat sometimes we kind of forget that word's noun form. For example, work, poverty. That is if you can't remember that word, if you can't there is no or realize that word means, it is easy for you take this type. That is adjective type. Here how we can write is easy. In spite of, next write down she into her, possessive noun. Next write down being. Why here we have written being means, this one is be form. What are be forms? Is, am, are, was, were. These five words are called be forms. Is, am, are, was, were. These five words are called, auxiliary words are called be form. Here is, am, are present form, was, were past form. So here is given, so present form. So here in spite of that being. So any five words anyone that comes means we have to write with being. If we write being means we have to write this adjective word as such. Don't change anything. So in spite of her being weak, she attends office. You note down in these three sentences, main class doesn't change. Okay, next one here, in spite of her being weak. So if you write being means, you have to write adjective word. If you, if you don't write being means, you have to write with noun form. So in the exam, you never remember that noun form. You don't know noun form means, you can select this type. Because if any that is the be form that comes means, you can write being. If you write being means, whatever here given, you have to write as such. You understand? I repeat once again. Although she is weak, she attends office, that is in complex form. While changing into compound, we have to remove this word although. You will get two sentences. Two sentences are joined by coordinating conjunction, but then you will get compound sentence. She is weak, but she attends office. Then while changing into simple sentence, first you will get in spite of, next one possessive noun, she into her, then write down noun form, weak adjective word, instead of that we have to write with noun form, weakness, next write down main class, or you can write with adjective type, for that in spite of, write down possessive noun, that is her, here instead of this is, weak form, What are the forms? Is, am, or, was, were. Anyone that comes means you have to write here being. In spite of her being, right? Being means whatever you are given adjective word, write down as such, then write down remaining features. You understand? Let's see the second sentence. He is sick, but he attends the rehearsal. That is in compound. With the help of this coordinating condition, but this sentence is in compound. Next one, we have to change it in complex means. We have to remove this word but. If we add though at first means, it will get complex. Though he is sick, comma, he attends the rehearsal. That is in complex. Now we have to change it in simple. First write down in spite of. Next one says subject he. Possessive noun his. Next write down noun form. Sick noun form. Sickness. In spite of his sickness. Main dance write down as such. He attends the rehearsal. That is in simple. Another form. This is noun form. You can write with adjective form. Adjective form or ing form. Here write down in spite of his. Write down being. Why we use already I told you. Be form. Is, am, or, was, where. For that we have to use being. Because that are called be form. Be form. So this is the main verb being. ING form means we have to add ING to this means we will get being. For that only. So in spite of this being sick. Afterwards write down that word adjective word as such. Sick he attends the rehearsal. So in spite of this being sick he attends the rehearsal. One more thing you should keep in your mind. Here if you write with noun form means don't add here being. Don't write ing form and noun form in the same sentence. Okay, ma, that is incorrect. So here in spite of this, after possessive noun, write down noun form. Here or in spite of this being, if you write means, we have to write with this adjective word sick. Don't use ing and noun form. Being sickness, that is wrong. So in spite of this being sick, if you attend to yourself. Why I mentioned that here two sentences means, sometimes if you don't remember noun form means, no problem. Here that be form the present is am or was or present means write down being. Afterwards whatever here given write down. That is very easy for you. So in spite of this being sick, he attends the rehearsal. So in the exam, anyone you can write, no need to write both sentences. But you should know the format. That is format of noun form and adjective form. How to write, you should know both sentences. Because in higher classes 11th and 12th means, you have to write both you can use. So you should know these two types, two sentences format. But in the exam you can write either one. Next one, despite his poverty, he lives a decent life. So here what sentence is this one? Despite, simple sentence. We have to change it in complex means. First you have to write with even though, although, or though even. So here I have used even though. See next one. That is when writing answer, we should keep all the things in our mind. We have to recollect, we have to recall all those things. Here his possessive noun, we have to write with noun form. That is a pronoun he. Next poverty noun form. We have to find out adjective word poor. He poor in our life because after subjective, then we have to write with verb. So to how we can find out verb? For that only come to main class. Which is main class? He lives a decent life. Here we have to find out verb. Which is verb? Lives verb. What tense this one? Lives present tense. Because yes here means for third person singular, we have added yes. So this one present tense. For present tense means we have to write the same tense here in the subordinate class also. So to find out tense we have to refer main class. Here whatever tense used we have to write with the same tense in the subordinate class. So here lives present tense. So we have to use here is. Here third person singular. Suppose instead of he. Here I that comes means you have to write I am for I am. So you have to keep clear by you means you are. So according to this subject, verb agreement, according to that subject, we have to select the auxiliary verb. You understand? So here even though, here I write on subject he, then we have to write verb. to write verb we have to refer tense in main class leads the present tense. Present tense means we have to write is, am, or anyone we have to select. He, see here subject he, so write down is. Even though he is poverty noun form adjective verb poor, and write down main class as such. Then we will get complex. Now we have to change it in compound sentence. Very easy for you. So remove this word even though. Then you will get two sentences. In between two sentences, you have to write down conjunction word but. Then you will get compound sentence. Very easy. He is poor. First letter should be in with capital letter. He is poor, but he leads a decent life. It is compound. You understand? Let's see next one. In spite of her hard work, Sheila could not score more marks. That is a simple sentence. In spite of. Next, we have to change it in compound complex meaning. First, you write down though. Next, then go through that sentence. Here, any name is given in the main class means we have to bring at first. So, write down here Sheila at first. Though Sheila. Next one, see here hard work. This is noun form. When writing, that is a verb means a work hard. That is, we can write either in verb or adjective. Here we use the adjective form, sick. But here we have to use the verb. Verb hard work means work hard. So write down work hard. Then work means present tense. I already told you, write down with the proper tense form. Whatever given in main class, that same tense we have to use in subordinate class. So here main class could not score. Could. What tense? Past tense. Can present form. Could past form. So we have to write here past tense. Work past tense. Worked hard. Though Sheila worked hard, comma, she could not score more marks. That is in complex. So again, individual in your mind, write down here though. Then afterwards write down name. Any name is given means bring name at first. Suppose here she given means no need here. No problem. Her means we have to write with she. Name given means bring at first. Though Sheila hard work now. So we have to write with verb means work hard. Here work means to refer. Before writing that verb, we have to refer here tense form. Could the past tense. So write down worked. Work past tense. Worked hard. She could not score more marks. In these three sentences, the main class doesn't change. Now, so suppose instead of could, can here present means Sheila cannot score more marks. Can present tense. That means here how you can write works hard. Because work present tense. Can present form yes. Present tense work there. But when writing present tense means we have to refer subject. Whether the subject is in first person, second person or third person. Here Sheila third person. She. Third person means we have to add yes to the verb. So here no need past tense means here we use the word in case. Here can present means if you write with present form means here works. Yes, we have to add yes. So though Sheila worked hard, she could not score more marks. That is in complex. So we'll change it into compound. Remove this word though. Then in between two sentences, write down conjunction word. Sheila worked hard, but she could not score more marks. That is in compound. Hope children, I hope all you understood this first try. So this is very important. If you know this means, the remaining types you can easily transform from simple to common, common to complex. You keep that, that is all the keywords in your mind for all types. Though even though like that, the word if you keep in your mind means, all the types are very easy for you to transform from one type to another type. Thank you all.